pray. Father, we thank you for this day. It is a very special day here at Journey Church. It's Compassion Sunday, and we're so blessed to have the Compassion Experience here with us today, where not only will we get to hear about compassion, we can experience in a virtual way what it's like for some of these kids. Particularly, we get to hear the story of Jonathan and Kiwi. We get to hear how their lives were changed by compassion. And Father, I pray that many people will participate in this. I know many people here are already sponsoring kids, Lord God, but we pray more would do it, that you would put it on our hearts, that we would be world changers, and that you would use this day as a very special day at Journey and in the lives of those kids who will be sponsored, and their lives will be different from forevermore as a result. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. So you've probably seen the videos in the weeks leading up to here where we rolled a little bit of the story of Jonathan, and we've also rolled the story of Kiwi and the little intros that we've done. Now you get to walk through a virtual experience of what that's all about today. I got to go through it on Friday. It is absolutely amazing. I have had the opportunity, and I'll share with you, to go with Compassion to Africa. We went to Rwanda and Kenya last year, and it brought so many flashbacks of that experience. It is world-changing. So many of you have not gotten to go on a missions trip yet. Can I say yet? Because we pray that every member of Journey Church at some point in their life will go on a short-term, if not a long-term, mission trip. You get an opportunity today to experience what life in another country is like and how groups like Compassion can really give them hope in Jesus Christ and can truly, truly change their destiny. So today, for me, is a very special day. So why don't we really start out with a definition? What does the word compassion mean? It means sympathetic pity and concern for the sufferings or misfortunes of others. It's something that sadly at times seems lacking in our generation, is it not? We seem to be a callous people. We look at the stuff that we see on TV, and sometimes it creates this world of disconnect for us. When you hear stories that seemingly are halfway around the world, even stories like we heard last week, when we are here worshiping in freedom, and then our brothers and sisters in Egypt got blown up while we're worshiping. But somehow we still can't fathom that, right? I mean, we can't understand it. If it comes through TV, maybe it seems like it's a movie and it's not real to us, but I assure you, there's real pain, there's real suffering, and there is real joy. There's real hope. I've met kids whose lives have been changed by the programs that we're going to be talking about today. I've seen it with my very own eyes, and many of you have been supporting them for over a year. We've supported 150 kids so far at Journey. Give God a little bit of glory. That 150 lives changed. That means the extent of Journey is well beyond the walls of what we see today, right? There is kids who are part of the Journey Church family in countries all around the world. Oh my goodness, many of you interact with them. We've heard some of your stories about how you shared notes and talked back and forth with them. If you haven't done that and you're a sponsor, I encourage you to do that. You'll get to, I assure you, I guess, that each and every face that you'll see on these cards in a moment, or each and every story you hear, is an absolute real person that you can talk to. It's not something fictitious. It's somebody that you can actually meet. Maybe when we go to Brazil, you will get to meet that. We'll talk about that a little bit later on during the course of our message as well. So compassion, sadly, it seems lacking in our generation. It stands in stark contrast to the darkness and selfishness of the human heart that we all fall into susceptibility about at times, right? Anybody here selfish and willing to admit it? Come on, I think all of us, it's not okay. God loves you as you are, but we need to all change, right? He wants to change us. He wants to transform us. He wants to help us in these things. He wants to give us hearts of compassion. And if I were honest, at times I lack a little bit of that. The things that I've experienced maybe have made me a little bit calloused, but you can't help but when you see pain around you, engage in that, and hopefully as a people, what Christians are called to do is love on one another and care for one another and be there for one another and embrace one another in those times of pain. That's one of the great benefits of being a part of the Ecclesia, the series that we're going to start next week, the called out ones, the body of Christ. We have people around us who we could share both the joys in life and the difficulties in life, right? See, when you try to go at it on your own, if you're not a member of God's family, it could be very difficult out there. It is a harsh and cruel world, but in the body of Christ, we have people around us who love us, care for us, and can be there for us through the ups and downs of life. And that's one of the things I really love about being a believer in Jesus Christ. So compassion should be a characteristic that should define every Holy Spirit-empowered believer. There's verses that give us hope, like Matthew 14:14. It says, when he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion on them, and he healed their sick. Mark 6:34 says, when he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, he had compassion on them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. There's hundreds of additional verses where Jesus looked at poverty or sickness or emotional challenges or physical challenges, and he touched people right where they were at, and he brought healing. He did it in such a miraculous way, but when we get to be used by him, is it any less miraculous? When we get to extend that hand of hope to someone else, when we see someone get healed, when we see someone delivered from the throngs of addiction, when we see somebody get set free, when we see a marriage saved, are any of those things any less a miracle? No, by no means. God is still at work in and through his people. He wants us to be like that Samaritan. Remember we talked about the Samaritan last week? We talked about the Samaritan woman and how people didn't like them. The Jewish people actually rejected them and were prejudiced against them. But there's that other story in the Bible about the Samaritan. When he saw the person hurting by the side of the street, he went out there and he bound up their wounds and he cared for them and he paid for them to be put up. And we need to be a little bit more like that Samaritan, do we not? See, life can be so fast and we drive by and we could miss the pains and the challenges of those around us, but God wants us as believers to be there to engage in those and bring hope and healing in the midst of those challenges that people face in life. He empowers us in our generation to do the same. How I pray that Journey would be blessed with the same kind of compassion that was found in Jesus' heart to do a work in our own generation. That God might stir a radical outreach and a radical generosity of compassion towards all the people both here and around the world who need our help. So people have asked us, like, what about here? You know, why are you going helping kids all around the world? It's not an either-or, Journey Church. If you know our heart, we'll share with you in just a moment. We want to do stuff here in our own backyard, and we want to do stuff around the world. Are you guys okay with that, right? We can do both. There's no reason that we cannot do both. We can do stuff here and around the world, and in fact, we do. Here's what we've really always used as part of our philosophy of ministry at Journey Church when it comes to missions. James 1:27, religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their affliction and to keep oneself unstained from the world. That we would go out and use our lives to make a difference in those who have no voice. So we've picked groups that you've met in recent months, like Seamark Ranch. If you don't remember what Seamark did, do you remember what they do? They're an orphanage right here in our backyard, right? So we can help children in our own backyard by continuing to support them. And when we bring them before you, we hope not only would you give them financial support or as we're doing corporately, but you, if you feel led, if God tugs on your heart, that you might engage and go volunteer with them as well, that you would get out of the walls of the church and go see things in a different context, because I assure you, when you do, it will change you. How about the Mercy Network that we support? Do you know what they do? They keep people who are on the edge of homelessness or who are homeless, and they try to get them back on the right track. They give them hope. They give them help. They have homes that we support. You might not even know this. We have homes that we help support where people who are homeless or in transition of that sort, where they have a roof over their heads because of you guys. Because you love Jesus so much that you're willing to give and sacrifice of your own resources that they might have hope. Or where I'm going to get to go and actually get to do the opening prayer of this Friday night, First Coast Women's Services, right? We believe in helping the unborn as well, right? We can help even before someone is born to ensure that they have a hope and a life, because we do believe in life here at Journey Church, right? So I get to do that. That's just a big honor this coming Thursday night. Or the In Ministry, who's here today, brings safety for women and their children, and we're proud and honored to be able to support them and the ongoing work that they're doing. In addition to the many projects like the backpack outreach, the annual Thanksgiving outreach, and the other things that you all so graciously participate in to try to make a difference, we are a church that loves and gives and serves and makes a difference. Would you give yourselves a big round of applause? I'm particularly happy about some of the new teams that have been rising up in the recent years that are internal groups that go out to the Salvation Army with the Staples and others on Friday nights, the Clara White Mission Team that goes out, Journey Out that goes out, and Streetside Prayer. All of you guys are doing an amazing job, and it looks like many of you are here in first service this morning. We commend you. Would you give them a big round of applause for all they're doing and going out and making a difference? So for those of you who might be exploring, looking for a church, that's our heart, to make a difference here and around the world. And we would ask you to join us. We would ask you to become a part of what God is doing in our generation. We're here really at a special day today as well, because the Acts 29 churches in our region, if you don't know, Journey Church is part of a greater network of churches. There's an excess of 500 churches around the world that all fly under the banner of Acts 29. And last year we met as a group, and the ones that were here in the greater Jacksonville area, and we said, how can we begin to make a difference around the world, and how could we leverage some of the partnerships that God has given us? And we said, we want to plant a church, because the heartbeat of Acts 29 is really church planting. So we got together and we talked in partnership with Compassion International, and we are working together. All five churches that are in the greater Jacksonville region are going to be planting a church down in Brazil. So there's 27 of us that are actually going to be leaving on May 16th, so pray for us. We're going to all go down there and meet the people who are going to be helping lead the church. We're doing it for the first time in partnership with Compassion. It's going to be an amazing partnership. So immediately as the church is planted, Compassion is going to be setting up one of their outposts. You'll get to see and hear a little bit more about that today. But every work that Compassion does, they partner with a local church in order to accomplish the work that they do and helping the kids. So we have a blessed opportunity where churches are working together. Have you ever heard of such a thing? Come on, Jesus. Should we not be doing that, right? We have five churches that are working together, pooling our money. That was part of that offering that we took up last week. All of those funds, last year when we did it, we helped do a water well for one of the works that they were doing. What a blessing. Life-giving water continues to flow at that particular Compassion outpost. And now we're going to get to plant a church down there. And for many of you who might be considering sponsorship today, the children that are on these tables are from Brazil. If you want a child that might be from an area outside of Brazil, you'll be able to go out there into the experience, and they have children from all around the world, if God should tug on your heart. But one of the reasons we wanted to specifically partner with Brazil within our congregation is because of the church plant, and we're going to be planning some short-term missions trips in conjunction with the other Acts 29 churches to go down to the outposts and help the church where we're actually working. So if you sponsor a child, there's a great chance that someday you could actually meet them. Come on, Jesus, right? So we pray that maybe many of you will take up on that particular opportunity. So I wanted to give you a heads up on what we're thinking and where we're going. Mary Jo and I continue to sponsor a young lady named Sherlyn, who's from Guatemala, and it's a great honor to continue that. And I'm looking for creative ways where we could do even more. The church does help sponsor some children directly. Our kids' church, you may or may not know it, but many of the rooms actually pull together, and with the kids' church offerings that they do, those kids actually sponsor some other kids as well. It's just such a blessing to see how they do that. You know, I'm thinking of ways where maybe the business that I have can sponsor it, or maybe you have other friends or businesses that you could partner with, or know that maybe your business or the ministry that you're involved in could sponsor a child as well. We just need to get really creative. Let me give you just a brief history about Compassion and their founding and what they continue to do today. More than 60 years ago, a preacher from Chicago flew to South Korea to minister to American troops fighting the Korean War. During this time in Seoul, the Reverend Everett Swanson grew increasingly troubled by the sight of hundreds of war orphans living on the streets, abandoned by society. Man, how relevant is this with what we're seeing going on in the world right now? One morning, he saw city workers scoop up what looked like piles of rags and toss them into the back of a truck. He walked up to the truck for a closer look, and he was horrified to see that the piles were not rags, but the frozen bodies of orphans who have died overnight in the streets. Swanson could not turn his back on these unwanted children and vowed to find a way to help them. He raised money to support a Korean orphanage and soon established a unique program that allowed individuals in the Western world to provide Bible-based education, food, clothing, shelter, and medical care for Korean orphans for a few dollars a month, embracing children and the remains at the heart of who they are as an organization, and have been doing so for over six decades as a ministry. They have changed literally countless thousands upon thousands of lives as a result. I believe today they're in 24 or more countries, and man, they are making a difference all around the world. They are worthy of Journey Church partnering with them. Their ministry is real. Their ministry is life-changing. Look at South Korea today. I mean, some of the largest churches on the planet actually are in South Korea. It is a society that has changed tremendously. It's one of the Asian communities that is thriving and making a difference all throughout the world. And I believe a lot of that has to do with the roots of when Compassion goes in there and they begin to teach these children the Bible. They begin to teach them about a relationship with Jesus Christ. Generations literally get changed. Let's look at what these other places that they're continuing to partner with kids in the days ahead. And I bet you're going to see those communities continue to thrive and begin to thrive in ways that we've never seen. Why? Because Jesus is at the root of all they are doing. And it is a great honor for us to partner with you who are here from Compassion today. There's some in the back. Would you give them one round of applause as well? So I want to share with you, if you weren't here last year, I want to share with you a little bit about the trip that we took to Africa. There's a few images that we wanted to share with you in a short video. They were gracious enough to take myself and Pastor Ed last year to Rwanda and to Kenya. You got any of those pictures there? Maybe we could take a look at a couple of them. The faces of the kids, I mean, oh my gosh, when you see them, and they would come up to us, and they call white people Mizungo. They'd be like, Mizungo, 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 and they'd make fun of us. It was funny. They thought it was really funny to see us there. That was a city. This is a great example of look at how clean it is there too. Think how amazing that is in Rwanda. They just have a culture where they make a difference. And many of these kids are Compassion kids that are living in this kind of cul-de-sac there. And we got an opportunity to interact with them. This was a beautiful thing. Some of Compassion's programs that the leaders could tell you about out there later, they have them geared towards different life stages. So this was one that we went to first that was absolutely beautiful because the death rate in the area that we were actually at, only 1 in 8 children survive. Get that for a minute. Think about it. 1 in 8. Compassion would teach these mothers things that we would take for granted, like brushing your teeth or like basic sanitation. And if these children get hooked up with a Compassion sponsor, their lives are changed forever. Their chance of survival goes through the roof. So this particular one trained moms. So when we got there, there was a bunch of moms with newborns who were all part of that experience. They go there and they get trained. They learn about the things that we in America take for granted. And they also teach them things like sewing or other trades that they would have an opportunity to use their skills to have a micro business that they could make a difference and be independent. Because sadly, you saw all those kids on the street there. How many dads did you see? Many of them are abandoned. It's just a very sad situation. We have a chance to give them hope. Man, the kids, how amazing is that? Any more pictures, or is that the last one? Let's look at them. Come on, Jesus. We have a chance to help them. What an opportunity stands before us. And I pray that we're going to seize the day in just a moment. There's a short video we actually filmed while we were there. We got to go to one of the Compassion Outposts. I'd like you to get a little glimpse of what it might look like.
Hey, Journey Church, we're in Kigali, Rwanda today at one of the Compassion International Projects. And it gives you an opportunity to just see, you know, them having a great time. They're worshiping in the background. You can hear the music behind us. The kids are out here playing. We just had an opportunity to feed them as well. Man, Compassion is doing a great work here and around the world, and it's our pleasure to partner with them. And Journey, as you have an opportunity to sponsor some of these children, I pray that we just step up to the plate. It's an incredible opportunity to make a difference in these kids' lives. They just told us that 80% of the fathers just abandon their kids, and for Compassion, many of these, this is their only hope. So we're just honored to partner with them and be here today, and we hope that you'll join us in that. God bless you guys.
Amen. I was telling Mary Jo, one of the hardest things to do, like at that very place, I remember, you'd be in there and you'd see the kids who are thriving and they're just excited, and you'd look outside at the kids who didn't get in the program yet, and I mean, you could just see the look of despair on their faces, and you want to help every single one of them, and obviously we can't, but you know, together we can continue to reach more of them. Together we can continue to help more of them, and it's just a life-changing experience. So I couldn't be more honored that Compassion Experience is here today so you could get just a glimpse of what that might be. And I hope it's hot as heck up underneath that tent so you can get the real Dominican experience up in there. You know, don't shy away from that. Experience everything about it, because they've done the very best that they can to give you a real glimpse of what life might be like in one of those communities. May it remind all of us not to take the things that we have for granted, and may it inspire some of us also to make a difference. My kind of final verses that I have for you today, 2 Corinthians chapter 8, starting in verse 1. It says, "We want you to know, brothers, about the grace of God that has been given among the churches of Macedonia. For in a severe test of affliction, their abundance and joy and their extreme poverty have overflowed with a wealth of generosity on their part. For they gave according to their means, as I can testify, and beyond their means of their wealth of their own accord, begging us earnestly for the favor of taking part in the relief of the saints." Man, I long for that day. We're saying, just how can I give? How can I make a difference? These are poor people they're talking about. "It's not as we expected, but they gave themselves first to the Lord and then by the will of God to us. Accordingly, we urge Titus that as he had started, so he should complete among us this act of grace. But as you excel in everything, in faith and speech and knowledge and all earnestness and in our love for you, that you excel in this grace also, this grace of giving, this grace of compassion." Might we live it out in our everyday lives. So yes, I'm here before you to ask you to give sacrificially. You know, I never ask you to do that for Journey Church. Whenever I've come before you, I ask you to do that for something outside of ourselves. The money's not for us. The money is to make a difference in the lives of these kids. We see these images of children and the ravages of war and poverty, and there can be that disconnect. But today I pray it becomes real to you, because every child on those cars is real, and we have an opportunity to really make a difference. So how can we respond? Let me give you some of the basics, and there'll be people there that can answer some questions as well. One, I would encourage you, don't leave immediately. Come up, and if you're feeling God already tugging on your heart, there's going to be people at each of the four corners. You can come up and look at the tables and see some of the lives and see a little bit of a glimpse of the stories of some of the kids who are on these papers. And if God so leads in your heart, there's different sponsorship levels, but the primary one is about $39 per month, where you can change a child's life and literally save them from poverty. I know statistically over 82% of the dollars that come into Compassion go directly to the children, which is a very good statistic. Every nonprofit has a little bit of overhead. They do everything they can to keep that overhead exceptionally low so that all the money can actually reach the children. If you choose to do so, there's a paper that's in there that you fill out and that you turn in before you leave. So you cannot take these cards with you. So if you need to think about something, you could certainly go online to compassion.com or compassion.org afterwards and do more and potentially sponsor that way as well. But we cannot take these cards with us because each card is a real child. If you lose that child, they will not get sponsored. So we cannot let them leave the room. So if you're choosing to do it, you step up to the plate and just go for it. And I pray that you do. And I know many of you already are doing it. I encourage everyone, go get your children. Take them with you. There's a small kid zone out there, but go begin to stand in line out there. Go through the compassion experience. That's part of your assignment for being here in church today. Go through the compassion experience. Do not leave here without walking through. If the line slows down a little bit, you're more than welcome to go through the other side. So like say you pick Jonathan versus Kiwi. If the line calms down, I would encourage you once it settles down a bit, you're welcome to go back through and see the other side if you feel so led. Would you rise with me and bow your heads and close your eyes? Ushers who are overseeing the tables, if you could please make your way to those areas. I'm not trying to tug at your heart, but what's tugging at my heart is when I think about the origins of compassion and they were throwing those rags that were actually kids into the garbage. How crazy is that? One of our partners, Joby Martin, Church of 1122, I love him dearly. We're going to get to spend time with him when we go to Brazil. He said, let us not be like that generation that was there tossing these kids aside. Lord, would we be a group of people that I know are already sacrificing? We, like the Macedonians on the west side of Jacksonville, are not a rich people. Many of us are just getting by, Lord God. But Lord, we have a chance to really make a difference. And we just thank you for this moment that you would even present us with this opportunity to lavish your grace on people that we don't even know. That we could have compassion on a people in Brazil who we don't even know or in other places around the world. I know that Journey is a generous bunch. And Lord, I pray right now, this very moment, that you will move on our hearts and that we would respond. As we close out this service today, I pray Deuteronomy chapter 16, verse 7, every man shall give as he is able according to the blessing of the Lord your God that he has given you. Maybe some were even struggling. They would team up with others and say, hey, let's do this together. We'll each pitch in $20. Father, would we truly use this moment as an opportunity to make a difference? We pause and pray over our children who are in the back right now, and we thank you for the grace that you've given us. They're back there playing. They're back there learning about Jesus. They're doing so in comfort. You've cared for them. You have loving parents who are here in this place, and we realize that that same thing doesn't exist around the world. Let it not be a TV show for us today, Lord God. Let that reality sink in that we have an opportunity to extend our family, so to speak. Father, we thank you for this moment. I thank you for the people of Journey Church. I thank you for the opportunity to pastor here. I thank you for the ups and downs of life as we described during our time of intercession. Let this be one of those up moments, Lord God. We thank you, we praise you, we give you glory. You are the King of the universe. In Jesus' name, amen.